Welcome to The Explainer. Have you ever wondered how an entire country, you know, keeps its finances straight with the rest of the world? Well, today, we're going to build a nation's balance sheet right from the ground up, from a single shipment of goods all the way to a massive international loan. Let's get into it.
So, how does a country balance its books with everyone else? I mean, every single day, billions of dollars are zipping across borders for everything imaginable. Cars, coffee, investments, even foreign aid. How does anyone possibly track all of that to figure out if a country is actually ahead or falling behind financially?
Well, believe it or not, there's an official system for this whole thing. It's called the balance of payments. The best way to think about it is like the ultimate financial statement for a country. Its job is to track every single dollar that comes in and every single dollar that goes out. So let's break down exactly how it works.
Okay, we're going to start with the part that's probably most familiar to all of us, the commercial balance. And it's pretty much exactly what it sounds like. It just tracks all the goods and services a country buys from and sells to the rest of the world. It's basically the nation's international shopping list.
Now, before we get to any numbers, we have got to get two key terms straight. On one side of the ledger, you have credits. That's any transaction that brings money into the country. Just think of it as income. And on the other side, you have debits. That's any money leaving the country. Think of those as expenses. Simple, right? Every single transaction from here on out will be one of these two. So let's plug in some simple numbers to see how this works. Let's say our country exports $100 million worth of stuff. That's money coming in, so it's a credit. But at the same time, the country imports $150 million worth of products from other places. That's money going out, a debit. So after all that buying and selling, where does that leave us?
We are in the red. $50 million in the red, to be exact. The country spent more on things from abroad than it earned by selling its own things.
And this negative number has a specific name. It's a commercial deficit. It just means that when you only look at trade, more money left the country than came in. But is that the whole story? Oh, not even close. You see, trade is just one piece of this puzzle. To really get the bigger picture, we need to zoom out a little to what's called the current account.
So what about all the money that moves between countries that isn't for a product or a service? Think about things like foreign aid or donations from charities or even money that people working abroad send back home to their families. These are called unilateral transfers. And trust me, they can have a huge impact on the final balance.
Let's look at some real-world examples to make this clear. When the U.S. provides aid to Israel, that's a credit for Israel. Dollars are flowing in. But when Israel provides aid to, say, build a hospital in Ukraine or sends a relief mission to Turkey after an earthquake, that's a debit for Israel. Dollars are flowing out.
Okay, so let's add these grants and aid figures to our balance sheet. Let's imagine our country received a whopping $250 million in grants, but only gave away about $20 million in aid. We just add those right on top of our trade numbers, and all of a sudden, the total income is $350 million, and the total expenses are $170 million. Wow, the picture has completely flipped. And just like that, we're not in a deficit anymore. After we account for all that aid, our country now has what's called a current account surplus of $180 million. But hold on, we are not done yet. There's still one more major piece to this puzzle.
All right, now we move to the financial account. This is where we track all the money that's flowing across borders for investment purposes. We're talking about buying stocks, real estate, or even making and repaying big loans.
Let's walk through the numbers here. So, for money coming in, we had foreigners buy $50 million in local stocks and $100 million in real estate. Plus, the government took out a $300 million loan. Add that all up, and you get $450 million in credits. But look at the money going out. Our own citizens bought $500 million in foreign stocks, and our government paid back an old $500 million loan. That is a full $1 billion going out the door.
So when you look at just the financial world, our country has a massive deficit of $550 million. Way more money left the country for investments and loan payments than came in.
All right, this is the moment of truth. We have our current account balance and we have our financial account balance. It's time to put it all together and see where our nation really stands with the rest of the world.
Now, the calculation itself is actually pretty simple. You just take the balance of the current account and you add the balance of the financial account. But there's a really common trap here that's super easy to fall into.
Here's the crucial thing to remember. You never add the commercial balance separately at the end. And why not? Because, remember, it's already included inside the current account.
If we added it again, we'd be counting that initial trade deficit twice, and that would mess up the whole thing. Okay, here they are, our two key numbers, a surplus of $180 million from the current account and a deficit of $550 million from the financial account. Let's add them together and get our grand total. And the final result is an overall deficit of $370 million. When you account for absolutely everything, all the buying, the selling, the aid, the investing, our country sent $370 million more out into the world than it took in. Now, this isn't just some abstract number on a spreadsheet. This is a real shortfall. A country can't just end the year with a negative balance, right? It actually needs to find $370 million from somewhere to make its books balance. So, where does that money come from? This is where a nation's emergency fund comes into play. It's foreign currency reserves. The easiest way to think about this is like a giant savings account that the central bank holds, and it's filled with other currencies, like US dollars or euros. Its main job is to cover shortfalls, exactly like the one we have right now. And this right here is the final step that makes everything balance out perfectly to zero. The central bank just dips into those reserves and uses $370 million to cover that deficit. The books are now officially balanced, but it came at a price. The nation's savings account just got smaller. And that leads us to the really critical question, doesn't it? I mean, balancing the books one time by using your savings, that's fine. But what happens to a country's economy, to its currency, to its standing in the world, if it has to do this year after year after year, just watching that emergency fund slowly drain away? That, right there, is the real story behind the balance of payments.